Today I will show you what is the transfer pay. In this presentation, I will talk about five items. First of all, I show you why there's so many transfer pays in Hong Kong and show you some examples and show you some of the technique of the using distressing and try to tell you how to make a simple design and some of the construction problems and construction difficulties for construction of transfer pay. First of all, you can see most of the old buildings in Hong Kong, they are not very tall. On the top, most likely they will have a residential building, and then to the bottom near the ground floor, it will be usually is a shop. You can imagine the layout is totally different, but if the building is not tall enough, the column size is very small, they can evenly distributed and no need to have a substantial transfer to the position. That's why you can see the layout is very regular in podium structure. They will have a longer span, let's say it's a 10 meter. From the above, you can see residential buildings, mostly they have a sheer wall and columns. They are quite close together, and then the space, and you can say sometimes it's about 3 to 5 meters. That means how can we design something with 5 to 3 meters for the shopping mall? It will be impossible. That's why normally we need to have a transfer structure like this one. You can imagine there's many walls with 3 to 5 meters, but if you're projecting to the podiums, it will be very difficult to design your shopping mall or something like this. That's why doing the transfer pay structure, you need to pay attention of the construction law and the shortening of the columns and the defection of the columns and the lateral defection. This is some of the example. It's a common layout of the residential building. You can see many walls on the above. Sometimes you can say it's a 3 to 5 meters, but if we want to have a shopping mall to the lower three-story buildings, you can see the layout should be have a larger span with a column layout with a larger, even the core wall should be located in the certain position. That's why we need to think about how can we change the layout and the position of the columns or core wall to make it much more wider. By the provision of the transfer pay, we can do it. This is the reason why we need to have a transfer pay. Another example, we show you something like this. This is a very typical residential building, but below the transfer pay, we need to have some ground floor with larger space to make the entrance be much more elegant and very special. That's why we need to have a transfer pay to transfer the sheer wall to be a columns like this one. This is another example of the hotel. We can see this is many columns on the above the hotel buildings, and then we want to have a car parking and the main entrance and the loading and unloading area on the ground floor. You can imagine if I provide so many columns without transfer, it will be impossible for me to design a car park or a loading and unloading area. That's why we must design something like this with a transfer structure to transfer all the columns above to just a few columns. Another super tall residential building. You can see this is a very typical residential building, many walls above. This is a transfer pay. We want to do something like this with columns below in order to make a so-called cup house, and then there's a parking place on the lowest floor. By provision of the transfer pay, you can see many walls above can be transferred to just a few larger columns, but we can design RAM in here. You can imagine if I continue to projecting the wall below, and this means we can no longer put our car RAM in here. That means the design need to redo again. And also, you can see the flexibility of the design will be less. This is another example. But the penalty is by the giving the design of the transfer plate, there's a substantial loading. That's why you can see the loading and the thickness will be very large. This is sometimes up to 4.5 meters. Another method is sometimes you don't want to have a transfer plate. Sometimes you can think about it as a transfer beam and the transfer truss. But remember, due to the loading, sometimes the size is also 3 to 5 meters. It will be very huge. And I was talking about some design assumption. First of all, in the past, there's a rule of thumb is talking about what is the estimated thickness of the transfer plate. Normally, we can take 10 stories is approximately with 1 meter. That means, for example, if you design a 40 stories building, the thickness should be about 4 meters. For the design of the transfer plate, normally we need to take care of the axial load and the moment. After that, we need to apply all the loading to the transfer plate, and then we can analysis by using the models of SAFE or even the ETAPS models. This is one of the examples. You can see there's many walls above the transfer plate. Below the transfer plate, we just have four huge columns, and this is a central core projecting downward. This is one of the examples, show you how to do it. This is another detail of the transfer plate. Normally, for the transfer plate, I can tell you the thickness is very large, and then how can we reduce it? This is by the provision of the post tensioning. This is one of the techniques, how try to reduce the meter, the depth of the transfer plate. Sometimes they can reduce from 3 meter to 2.5 or to 2 meter. It depends on the loading of the residential buildings on the above. This is some of the example why we need to reduce the pace, because you can imagine the 3 meter is very huge, the concrete volume is very large, and also we want to reduce the overall height of the building. That's why we want to use the post-stressing technique. Post-stressing, post-tensioning is something like this. They provide the tendon and try to take the tension force. It's more or less is like the performance of the steel reinforcement, but the tendon, they can take much more tension force. That's why the effective of reducing the height is much more higher. This is one of the example. Try to apply the loading of the shear walls, and then to certain cases in the past, we assume this is a very thick beam to design a so-called the transfer plate model. This is an outcome of the transfer plate. We just provide the tendon between the plate, and you can take the large substantial tension forces. This is one of the example. You can imagine this is about 10 to 15 meters column width, and above is a residential building. This is another example. You can see this is a transfer column with a transfer plate. Above, you can have a different closer space columns and wall. Another example you need to pay attention is that during the construction, we need to have a design of the temporary work properly. Remember, they need to have a vertical popping. Normally, we need to have a base in order to make there's a lateral movement to make the transfer plate collapse. For example, this is about 2 meter depth. The dead load and construction load is very large. That's why we have to maintain a closely spaced popping. To certain cases, if we don't have the enough spaces, sometimes we can transfer by using the design of the temporary steel truss. This is the end of the presentation. Thank you.